Yeah, we're looking at this question, find the particular solution for this equation. And if you check this equation, this is second order differential equation, which is a non-homogeneous. And then we have the right-hand side, we have this function, we have two different functions. So the first thing for us to do, we do the get the yH, get the homogeneous part of the equation. Then after that, get the particular solution. We're going to get the yH, okay? Let's get this, which will be equal to what? Solving for the homogeneous parts by equating to zero, solving the homogeneous parts, okay? And the auxiliary equation will be differential. If it's first differential to be R, if it's second differential to be R squared. The one without differential, you're only writing the coefficient of that attachment to your y, that's plus one. Yeah, and this will be equal to R will be equal to R squared will be equal to minus one. So R will be equal to plus or minus I. When you differentiate minus one, you get a complex number. Okay? So this one now is ideally supposed to have the real parts and the complex parts. So we don't have the real part. The alpha is not there. The alpha is zero. So the solution. The solution, let's see, y1 be equal to e 0, your alpha is 0. I write this one as 0 plus plus or minus I. Where the 0 is the alpha, where this one, the coefficient of this I, there's one here. So we call the object beta. And that will be the angle. Y1, the solution of the differential equation y1 is equal to what? So this is cos x. And this is what sine x. And don't forget, when the root of the auxiliary equation is a complex root, the formula is very simple. Your y1 be equal to e alpha x cos beta x, and the y2 be equal to what? E alpha x sine beta x. But that is the solution for the for the differential equation, okay? So then in this case now, we don't have the alpha part, we don't have the real parts, okay? So that's what we call it, another zero, okay? Then the complex part, the attachment to that is your one, which is your beta, okay? So that's that on that case. So my y1 is cos x, my what? My y2 is sin x. So the general solution for the homogeneous part will be equal to c1 y1, which is cos x, plus c2 y2 is what? Sin x. So that's the what? That's the homogeneous part. Then the next thing to do is to divide the equation into two parts. Then your yp can now be superimposed. You can add them together, yp1, yp2. So let's get the yp1. Okay? For the yp1, look at this, what we have here. You realize that your R1, R2, R1, R2, they are not equal to what? The root of, the what generate this one is, what's the attachment here? The real part is what? Is 1 plus or minus what? Plus or minus I. Okay, so none of this, none of the root of the auxiliary equation generate this. Okay, that's one observation. Then the particular solution for this expression, when your equation start with ex exponential and cosine, is very simple. It just be a what you have here, ex cos x plus what bx ex sine x. Okay, if the two of them equal to your function, equal to the root of this that generate this function, because for you to get this function you must have this root. If one of them is equal to this, then you have to multiply this expression by what? By a second differential. You must have gotten your first differential. So let's get the yp1. Yp1, the first differential of this. Let's differentiate this one first, the exponential one. So that'll be dx cos x. Then and see here again. Can you differentiate the cos now? that'll be minus, if you differentiate cosine, that'll be minus sine x. So that'll be minus ex sine x. It's a product rule. A is your constant. Okay, I'm keeping this, I kept this one constant in the first instance, and I differentiated ex, exponential function. Then the second part, I now differentiate this one, and derivative of cosine is minus sine x. You can see, and I keep this one constant. Then for the second part, I'll do the same thing also. That'll be plus, differentiate this one, plus b ex sine x. Then plus, now differentiate your sine now. That's a b ex cos of. Second differential, b1. this one, if we do, let's do the explanation first. That'll be a ex cos x. Okay, then minus, if we differentiate cos, that'll be minus a ex sin x. A ex sin x. Sure. Differentiate the exponential, we have this. Then we have this. That's correct. Okay, for this one, there's a minus here. So we need to be aware of that. So I can open the brackets. I can open the brackets. Differentiate the exponential first. So I have this one. Then plus. Plus. Now differentiate your this one. That'll be a ex cos what? Cos x. Then you can close that. You can close that. Okay. Then come back here. The reason I open bracket is because of this negative. That's why I open the bracket. Then here now for this one, then I have b plus b ex sine this, then plus b ex cos this. First differentiate this. Okay. Keep this on constant. The second part, now differentiate your sine. Then the last one, we've done the second differential, then we can now go and substitute there. And that will be equal to, therefore. But before we substitute, is there anything that cancels out? Let's check. Yeah, if you open this bracket, minus A. That's minus. That's A, ES, exponential, cos. So this and that last one cancel out. Cancel out. So I have now this one and this one, that's minus g, minus g, a, ex, sine x, minus g. Okay, then this one also, b, exponential sine, and this one cancel out. So I have it, plus 2b, ex, cos x. So that's my second differential. Then plus y. So that's what I have there for my y, p1. Then, what next now? Factorize now. Let's begin factorize. I want to factorize ex sine x. Ex sine x. Plus b. Then the next one, ex cos x. Okay. You got what? 3 ex cos x. Then you can equate the coefficients. I can equate the coefficients of ex sine x. And that will be what? Minus 2a. Plus b. Do we have on the right hand side e exponential ex sine x? We don't. That's equal to zero. Then the second one, that'll be 2b plus a. 2b plus a equal to 3. If you equate that, equal to 3. Okay, equal to 3. So, what again can we do now? From here, from this place, b is equal to what? 2a. Okay? So, can you put it here? So, anyway, you see b, you have 2 into bracket 2a plus a equal to 3. So, this is be 4, that's 5a equal to 3. So, a is what? 3 over 5. Then you can get your b. So, your b is equal to what? 2 times what? 3 over 5. And that's 6 over 5. So with that now, my YP1, my YP1, what's the general solution? Is there. That's A. My A is what? 3 over 5 EX cos X plus B, 6 over 5 EX sin X. So So that's my wife, she wants. So I will not do for the, so we are having for the second part, we're going to have, you know, that we stated before, equal to 5 sine what? Sine x. Okay? So that's the second part of the equation. And that's what we want to do now to get the yp and yp2. Okay? And don't forget also, be reminded that your homogeneous parts is equal to what? Is equal to cos x. C1 cos x plus C2 sine x. Okay? So, in that case now, you realize that yp2 is equal to, when you have sine, okay, this 5 is just a constant. When you have sine, that starting to just be equal to a, open your bracket, a sine x plus b cos x. If you sine that starting, you start with sine cos. Okay? And then you realize that, you realize something, your roots, you check the question, our roots, the R1, R2 is equal to, is equal to what? Plus or minus what? I. You go to that function. So in that case now, you have to multiply by what? By x. That's multiplied by x. Because one of the roots is the same as that. Yeah. Now, if you don't want to say it that way, one of your root of the auxiliary equation is sine x, which is also sine x here. So just multiply whatever you have there. Like that. Okay? So, what do we do now? Can we get yp first differential? yp1, let's get the first differential of this. But before we get the first differential, can we try to expand that bracket? We have the first differential. First differential, let's do that. Let's differentiate this one. That'll be a sine x. Then plus. Keep this one constant now. Differentiate this. That'll be x cos what? Cos x. Okay, then come back here. Differentiate this. That'll be b cos x. Then differentiate this now. And that'll be what? Minus b x sine what? Sine x. So that's the first differential. Can we do the second differential? Second differential, b2. Here, this will be what? Differentiation of sine is cos. Cos x. Here, put that through. That will be plus a. I'm differentiating x. That will be a cos x. Then follow by, what they call it? Follow by, now keep this one constant. That will be ax sine x. I mean, differentiate this one now. Keep this one constant. Differentiate this. That will give you that. Then come back here. Differentiate your cos. This is constant. That is minus b sine x. And then here, at the minus here, you must be very careful. If you differentiate this, that will be what? Minus b sine x. And then this minus also will make the next one to be minus. Okay? That's minus bx cos x if you differentiate your sign. So we've gotten the we've gotten that. Let's see what cancel out here. Okay, so this is equal to, this is equal to this 2, that's a 2a, 2a cos x, then minus ax sine x, and then this one, that's minus 2b sine x. Then followed by minus bx cos x. Okay, I think I'll have to do everything straight away without wasting time. Therefore, so substitution now, second differential plus y, and my y is what? Cancel out. So equal to what? Equal to 5 what? 5 sine what? 5 sine. 5 sine x. So let's begin to equate the coefficient. We have now 2a cos x, 2a cos x minus 2b sine x, 2b sine x, 2b sine x, equal to 5 watts, 5 Fm/x. So then that means Marvin minus 2B. If you equate the sign, that's minus 2B equal to 5. So B is what? Minus 2B over 2. Then for the one, of course, that'll be 2A equal to 0. So A is what? A is 0. Okay, so therefore, YP2 is equal to, so we just have minus 5 over 2. Minus 5 over 2, your AX, A is 0, so this one cancel. So minus 5 over 2 X cos X. That's that. Okay, YP will be equal to, check that. What do we have for the YP one is here? So that'll be 3 over 5 EX cos X. Okay, plus 6 over 5 EX. X. Then for the YP2, minus 5 over 2 X cos X. Okay, so that's what we get there. Just YP we are looking for, and that's our YP for that question.